Lord Taylor of Warwick.
My lords, I would also like to thank the noble Lord, Lord Chigi, for securing this timely debate. I'm also delighted to follow the noble Lord McNally, who made such powerful points. It was Henry Ford who said, "Don't just find fault, find a remedy." We have all attended conferences and summits which have been more talk than walk, more activity than action. This is why it is vital that there are real outcomes from the next Commonwealth Summit, encompassing the findings of the People's Forum and the Parliamentary Forum. It is essential because there are compelling facts about the Commonwealth, which the noble Lord, Lord Parrock reminded us. It makes up nearly one third of the world's population. Trade within the Commonwealth is projected to be worth $1 trillion by 2020. It has a shared history, yet is so diverse. Every 4 years, the Commonwealth Games presents an attractive window through which that good news is viewed. Furthermore, the summit itself is an important marker as to the issues and future direction of the nations that the Commonwealth oversees. But more than the facts, the Commonwealth is a family. My father came to Britain in the late 1940s after serving as a sergeant in the British 8th Army in the Second World War. As a Jamaican, he was a member of the Commonwealth, and in coming to England, he did not see himself as travelling to foreign parts. He was coming home to the motherland. Sadly, although he was a qualified accountant, the only job he could get was as a toilet cleaner at a factory in Birmingham. But his fortunes changed when Warwickshire County Cricket Club discovered that he could play cricket. The headline in the local sports Argus was "Warwickshire sign Jamaican immigrant." But the following year, in 1949, when he'd scored 121 not out against Leicestershire, the headline then read "Warwickshire saved by local Brummy Taylor." His story, and that of many immigrants to Britain from the rest of the Commonwealth, builds upon that concept of family and belonging. So it was a personal joy and honour for me, 54 years after my father had left Jamaica to live in England, to visit Jamaica myself to open up a new orthopaedic hospital in Kingston. The hospital staff were rather surprised when I mentioned that I lived near Kingston. So I had to clarify that I meant Kingston upon Thames. Although the Commonwealth Heads meeting is essentially a political and diplomatic event, it should recognise that the various faith groups in the Commonwealth have a role to play in its future. In Britain, as in other Commonwealth countries, there are Christian, Jewish, Muslim, Hindu, Sikh and other faith communities that are networks of leadership and expertise. There needs to be more of a partnership between government and such groups in tackling such issues as terrorism, migration, human rights, poverty and equality. In Britain alone, there are about 5,000 black majority churches. Black churches attract thousands of people to each service. The congregations are mainly from Africa and the Caribbean. I've had the honour of being a keynote speaker at many of these churches, including at a major church congress in Lagos, Nigeria. Many of these faith groups are professional people. They are part of the wider Commonwealth diaspora, living and working in Britain, that is waiting in the wings, my lords, to help with the ongoing problems which have been articulated in this debate. Will the noble minister indicate whether the government has a strategy to embrace the potential contribution of these faith groups? The CPA UK, as we know, will be hosting the first ever Commonwealth Parliamentarians Forum next year. Also, the People's Forum will be Chogham's platform for civil society groups across the Commonwealth to engage with leaders and influence society. The Parliamentarians Forum's main themes are very much about the future, as we've heard. They will also encompass gender, youth, and diaspora engagement. I understand the CPA UK will soon be meeting with the head of programmes of the People's Forum to discuss their respective agendas. There will also be a parallel Commonwealth Business Forum and Youth Forum at the time of Chogham. I know the CPA are keen that the Parliamentarians Forum effectively influences discussions at Chogham, but more importantly has a long-term impact beyond Chogham in holding members states to account for their objectives. I, indeed the CPA UK, are keen to hear the Noble Minister's views on how this could be done effectively. My Lords, by listening to the voices of the people, as well as the parliamentarians, we can ensure that the summit will be about value, not just volume.